Aditi, Dr. Ramya was unable to join us due to a family emergency, and we did not want to skip the talk, so I'm just going to go through a few of her slides. Please bear with me. Customizing keratoplasty for our patients. As the last talk of the session, we had given her a brief as to give us some options as to where keratoplasty we need to think out of the box in certain situations. Every one of us loves this kind of a graft that is clear, it is shiny, and the patient is happy, and so is the surgeon. But we all know that this is just the beginning, and penetrating keratoplasty, once done, actual job of the surgeon begins. We have always this fear of a failed graft, of a vascularized graft, of infections related to sutures, which are hanging on our heads. Worst case is a trivial trauma, which can cause this kind of a dehiscence and the loss of vision for these patients. So what are the statistics and what do they tell us? A survival rate at 5 years period is quite high in every PK, it's 82%. However, only 55% of the grafts survive beyond 15 years, which means half the grafts that we do today are going to fail in 15 years' time. If we remove keratoconus from this cohort, the results look even worse. A second graft fares much worse. So always think 100 times before you put in a first graft in these patients. A third corneal graft has a five-year survival rate of zero practically. And apart from that, all the issues related to PK, astigmatism, rejection, failure, long-term need for steroids, and the associated risks for that, glaucoma and risk of losing the eye to minor trauma are always hanging on our heads. Then came the thought of a lamellar graft. You decrease the amount of immunogenic tissue that you are actually transplanting. And endothelial was first pioneered by Dr. Jose Barraca in 1960. But it was because of unpredictable results was not really something that took on. In 1998, Dr. Mellis performed the first posterior lamellar keratoplasty on a live patient, and he called it the PLK. It was further modified by other surgeons to DSEC, and then DMEC followed. Work on DALK has, however, started 150 years ago. Endothelial keratoplasties can be penetrating, or sorry, can be a DSEC or a DMEC, as is the rage these days. And they also have their own problems associated. Sorry, yeah. So a little bit about DALK. They have a better graft survival. There are lesser chances of rejection, safer for large grafts, no open globe issues while doing the surgery, and can be used. We can use a little slightly lesser quality tissue as well. These kind of patients who are maybe one-eyed, who have a single eye, and if DALK is possible, then they have a quicker visual recovery and they do better than if there is a PK done for these patients. This is another case for which PK was done. Bowman layer transplant is the new kid on the block and has been again started by Dr. Mellis in Rotterdam, and this kind of there is a very specific subset of keratoconus patients in whom you want to avoid a keratoplasty, either full thickness or lamellar keratoplasty, and Bowman layer transplant can be an option. However, there is a steep learning curve, and even though the results that are shown by the two groups that do it are promising, it will require further doing before something can be said about how often or how well everybody can take this procedure up. So how do you customize a full thickness graft? In banana grafts may be required in peripheral melts like are shown here, and patch grafts are required at times where this is a more of a tectonic procedure. You want to avoid a larger tissue. Probably later another graft or contact lenses can help improve the vision of these patients. Role of femtosecond laser is definitely something that we look forward to in the future. Of course, for that, femtosecond laser has to become more accessible to all of us, and the various configurations through which femtosecond lasers can help us fashion grafts are shown here. suturing is various ways of suturing will help us customize the grafts for our patients and patients who are one-eyed, who require a faster visual rehabilitation. Probably a combination of continuous with interrupted sutures can help us. Special situations can be where rotational autografts are tried. Autograft from the other eye, something very controversial and probably best left to the discretion of the surgeon. Special thanks to Dr. Bhaskar Srinivas.